Hello everyone, in this lecture today I'm going to talk to you about regulation of genes in eukaryotes. Okay, I'm going to talk about promoters, transcription factors, and how the genes in eukaryotes are regulated to ultimately make the protein. Okay, so before I begin, let me first begin by talking briefly about the central dogma of molecular biology. What is the central dogma of molecular biology? In central dogma of molecular biology, what happens is that DNA makes the copy of DNA with the help of enzyme called DNA polymerase. This process is called replication. Okay, DNA makes DNA. This is called replication. And from the DNA, the RNA is made. Okay, from the DNA, RNA is made. So from DNA, DNA makes RNA. That process occurs with the help of RNA polymerase, and this is called transcription. Okay, DNA makes RNA. That is called transcription. And RNA polymerase is the enzyme involved. And from RNA, finally, a protein is made. So this process is called translation. Okay? So DNA makes DNA, that is replication. DNA makes RNA, this is transcription with C. And RNA makes protein translation with S. So this whole process is called central dogma of molecular biology. So first, this concept you have to understand. So genetic information is transferred from the DNA to RNA and finally in the form of protein. Okay, so now that I have talked about what is central dogma of molecular biology, now I want to talk to you about the promoters. What are promoters? Promoters are a vital component of expression vectors or expression system because they control the binding of RNA polymerase to the DNA. Okay, so these actually promoters are really important because they control the binding of RNA polymerase to the DNA. They are about 100 to 1000 base pairs in length. In eukaryotic organisms like humans, the main RNA polymerase in our cells actually does not directly bind to the promoters. Okay, so like in bacteria, the promoters, the RNA polymerase bind directly to the promoters, but in eukaryotes it doesn't bind. So instead, the helper proteins, basically they are called central transcription factors. They bind to the promoter first. Okay, these central transcription factors, they bind to the promoter first, helping the RNA polymerase in our cells to get foothold on the DNA. Okay, I know that it's very confusing, a lot of words. Now I will show you the picture and I will explain you how this process occurs. So more theoretical part. So basically in eukaryotes, promoters have a specific sequence called the tetra box, and this plays a major role, like, you know, 1010 element in bacteria. This tetra box is recognized by the general transcription factors. It allows other transcription factors and eventually RNA polymerase to bind. It also contains lots of A's and T's, which makes it easy to pull apart the strands of DNA apart. Okay, so this is a lot of theory. Now to the picture. Okay, so what is a promoter? Just look at this picture here. This picture here shows the DNA. In the DNA, in the promoter part, like I have mentioned here, you know, many eukaryotic promoters, they have a specific sequence called TATA tetra box. What is tetra box? It's basically thymine and adenine. This box is called tetra box because it has thymine and adenine, TATA. That's why it's called tetra box. And where this promoter part is present? It is present upstream. Okay, so this is the sequence of the gene to be coded to RNA and finally to the protein. So this tetra box is present upstream of the gene. Okay, so the promoter, the part of the promoter, this is a tetra box. Okay, 5'. So this is a tetra box. This is the promoter, right? And this is here +1 is the transcription start site. This is where transcription starts, and this tetra box is present upstream. Okay, fine. So the promoter, like I have mentioned here, many eukaryotic promoters, they have a specific sequence that's called the tetra box. And in these tetra boxes, this tetra box is actually, it is recognized by general transcription factors. So basically what happens? First, these transcription factors, okay? So transcription factors, they are the proteins, okay? These proteins, regulatory proteins, they bind to the definition, the details of which I will get back to you about the details of transcription factors in the later slides. So these transcription factors, the regulatory proteins, they bind to the TARA box, okay? And then now the more specific transcription factors, they come and bind. And finally, then this RNA polymerase binds, okay? So this is they form this transcription initiation complex, and then they initiate the transcription of the gene, okay? This is the part which is to be transcribed, right? So what is a promoter then? The promoter is a part where these transcription factors and the RNA polymerase enzyme, and they bind in the DNA. The transcription is a part of a DNA which is present upstream of the gene, okay, at the 5' site. This is upstream. And so here, transcription factors and this RNA polymerase, okay, they bind. Okay, this is a promoter. So and the transcription factors, you know, why they bind to the TATA box, TATA box, it is A double bond T, because this A double bond T, it's a weak bond, okay? It has two bones, it's a weak bone, and therefore, there are a lot of A's and T's which makes it easy to pull the strands apart of the DNA, okay? These strands can be easily pulled apart because it's a weak bond. For example, Z triple bond C is a strong bond, okay? So it's hard to pull apart here. So I have explained here, so the basic definition of promoters, okay? So now, I have talked about promoter. I want to now talk about transcription factors, okay? In molecular biology, transcription factors or sequence-specific DNA binding factor is a protein, okay? They are proteins that controls the rate of a transcription of a genetic information from DNA to messenger RNA by binding to a specific DNA sequence, and this is actual promoter. So what promoter present in the DNA, okay? So what is the function of the transcription factor? Transcription factor, because they regulate transcription, right? So as the name suggests, they regulate transcription, they turn on or turn off the genes. They turn on and turn off the genes in order to make sure that they are expressed in the right cell. They are expressed in the right cell at the right time, in the right amount throughout the life of the cell and the organism. So transcription factors, they turn on and turn off the genes, and they regulate the expression of the genes so that it is expressed at the right time, in the right cell, in the right amount throughout the life of the cell and the organism. So now I'm going to talk about the structure of the transcription factors, schematic structure. So basically it has mainly two domains. There is one optional domain. So basically DNA binding domain, one domain that's called DNA binding domain. DNA binding domain of the transcription factor attaches to the specific DNA sequences that are upstream of the regulated gene, okay? So this specific region is called a promoter, right? And the other is transactivation domain. So in this transactivation domain, where other proteins, co-regulatory proteins, bind to the transcription factor. So these transactivation domain. And there is another third element sometimes present that's called signal sensing domain. This region, when present, it allows signaling molecule to bind to the transcription factor. A lot of theory I have discussed here. Now I will show you the picture here that will make the things clear. Okay, so the transcription factor, this is the schematic structure. What is it? It is a protein that controls the rate of transcription of a genetic information from DNA to the messenger RNA by binding to a DNA sequence, that is the promoter. So transcription factors has mainly two domains, that is DNA binding domain and another is transactivation domain. The DNA binding domain of the transcription factors, it binds to the DNA at the promoter, right? At the promoter sequence. What is this transactivation domain? Transactivation domain. Other proteins, okay, so the co-regulatory proteins, other co-regulatory proteins, they bind at the transactivation domain, okay? The DNA binding domain, this domain binds to the DNA, okay? But this transactivation domain, the other co-regulatory proteins bind at this domain bind to other co-regulatory proteins. And signal sensing domain, okay, this is not always present, usually present, and when present, this allows signaling molecules to bind to the transcription factor. Okay, signaling molecule can bind to the transcription factor. So I hope that now you are clear about the concept of transcription factor. It's a regulatory protein. So it has majorly mainly two domains, DNA binding domain and transactivation domain. DNA binding domain binds to the DNA, transactivation domain binds to DNA binding domain, this binds to the DNA, whereas transactivation domain, this transactivation domain, it binds to the regulatory proteins. Whereas signal sensing domain, it binds to the sensing signaling molecules. Okay, so this is a transcription factor. So now, so look at this picture here, okay? This is the gene that is to be transcribed, right? Upstream of the gene, we have the promoter in eukaryotes. This is all I'm talking about, eukaryotes, okay? This is the gene to be transcribed, and the promoter is present upstream of the gene to be transcribed. Okay, so this is TATA box here. And further away, there are activators, okay? And these, enhancers. And in this enhancer, this is enhancers, these activators can bind. That's a distal control. Okay, so the first thing is that activator proteins bind to an enhancer region in the DNA, okay? So this is the structure of the DNA. The structure of the DNA has the gene to be transcribed. At the upstream, we have the promoter. This has TATA box. And at the distal regulation, we have enhancer or sometimes silencer, okay? They can also be the silencer. So what happens? The activated protein, okay, this is an activated protein, it binds to the enhancer, okay, activated proteins bind to an enhancer region in the DNA. This enhancer region is present in the DNA, really far away from the gene to be transcribed, not like promoter, which is present in almost in close proximity to the gene to be transcribed, right? So the next thing is, then DNA bending proteins bring the bound activators close to the promoter. Okay, so what happens then? Okay, this is the structure, right? So I talked, this is a DNA. This DNA has enhancer and promoter and the gene to be transcribed. And in the enhancer, when these activators bind, okay, so activators bind to enhancer region in the DNA. Okay, fine. Then what happens? Then this DNA bending proteins, okay, DNA bending proteins, they bind. DNA bending proteins, what they do is that these DNA bending proteins bring the bound activators. Okay, now the activators are bound to the DNA, and DNA bending proteins, they bend the DNA and bring these activators closer to the promoter. Okay, here is our promoter. Okay, so this DNA binding domain, it bend the DNA. Before it was like this, now the DNA has bent, and they bend these activators close to the promoter. Okay, so DNA bending domains, proteins, sorry. So now activators bind to the transcription factors. Okay, so now they are close to the promoter. Here we have, this is a group of mediator proteins, and there are transcription factors, right? So what happens is that then these activators, they bind to these central transcription factors and mediator proteins, okay? It has bent and now they have come close, so they bind to general transcription factors and a group of mediator proteins. So activators bind to general transcription factors and mediator proteins, forming a translation initiation complex. Okay, so they form a translation initiation complex. So then after that, the complex, so we have these all three things are bind, so they have translation initiation complex has been formed. So like here, so you see these activators, they have come together to these. This is a mediator protein. These are transcription factors. Now, this complex promotes the binding of RNA polymerase to the promoter, okay? So the enzyme is the RNA polymerase too, specifically. So this, what this does is that this complex, this transcription initiation complex, it promotes the binding of RNA polymerase to the promoter, okay? So this RNA polymerase enzyme, they promote the binding of this RNA polymerase enzyme to the promoter region, right? And then it enhances the gene expression, okay? Now then the gene will be transcribed, okay? RNA synthesis will occur. Gene will be transcribed from DNA, RNA will be made. Okay, so I want to now summarize here what happens. So this is the schematic structure of a DNA. In this DNA, we have the gene. This is to be transcribed. Upstream, we have the promoter. And really further away, we have enhancers. There are these molecules called activators. These activators, they bind to the enhancer, okay? Region in the DNA. Enhancer region in the DNA. Okay, first they bind. And after that, DNA bending proteins. So then DNA bending proteins, they bring these activators Okay, these bring activators closer to the promoter. Okay, these activators closer to the promoter. So then these activators bind to the transcription factors. They bind to these transcription factors and also to a group of mediator proteins. Okay, so activators bind to transcription factors and also to group of mediator proteins. These are transcription factors and they are mediator proteins, right? And then they form a complex. So this complex is called transcription initiation complex. Now, this transcription initiation complex, what it does, it promotes the binding of RNA polymerase. Okay, it promotes the binding of RNA polymerase to specifically to the promoter, right? Once this RNA polymerase enzyme, this binds to the promoter, now the transcription of this gene occurs and the synthesis of RNA occurs, okay? So, you know, this slide here will just be the repetition of the previous slide to give you the better understanding of the concept. So this is the coding region of the gene, right? This is the gene to be transcribed. This is the promoter present upstream, and this is the enhancer sequence. So in the enhancer sequence, the activator binds, and DNA bending proteins also bind. So then what happens? So transcription factors and other mediator proteins and activators, they form transcription initiation complex, and they promote the binding of RNA polymerase enzyme, ultimately leading to the protein synthesis. You just need to refer to the previous slide for the detailed explanation. Okay, so now a bit more clearer picture of how the process of transcription occurs. Okay, just look at this picture. First look at here, okay? So the thing here is this. Okay, so here we have, this is an open reading frame. That is, this is the part to be transcribed, part gene to be transcribed. 5' on translated region, and upstream we have a promoter. Of course, promoter is a proximal promoter and core promoter. You know, they are divided into different types, proximal and core. And really further away, we have enhancer or silencer, like I said before. And on the 3' side, we have 3' on translated region and enhancer or silencer. They can present also here in the 3' side also, okay? So this is the schematic structure of the gene, right? So these are regulatory sequence, this enhancer and silencer. They are regulatory elements, promoter, of course, 5', 3', 5' on translated region. So they are actually regulatory sequences. Same here, enhancer, silencer, 3' on translated region, and terminator, they are also regulatory sequences, right? The transcription occurs, okay? How transcription occurs, I have already explained. So the transcription occurs, then what happens is that then we will have this free mRNA transcript, which will contain exon. These are coding sequences. Intron, they are non-coding sequences. So exon, intron, coding and non-coding sequences. This is a 5' untranslated region and 3' untranslated region. Here will be the terminator. Then addition of the 5' cap and polyethyl occurs. Okay, so basically introns will be removed. Introns will be removed. Then we'll have exons only. This is called splicing. You can refer to my previous videos on how splicing occurs. 5' cap is added on the 5' end, 3' polyethyl to prevent this mRNA to degrade. And from this mature mRNA, then translation occurs. Ultimately, protein is synthesized. Okay? So I hope this video was helpful. Thank you very much for your kind attention.